Oke. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera. Terima kasih rakan-rakan yang saya hormati. Pada hari ini bagi pihak Pakatan Rakyat, saya telah kemukakan surat kepada Perdana Menteri memohon diadakan sesi parlimen dengan segera, tidak lewat dari Selasa 23 September untuk membahaskan usul yang berbunyi bahawa Dewan Yang Mulia ini telah hilang kepercayaan kepada Yang Amat Berhormat Dato' Seri Abdullah Mat Badawi sebagai Perdana Menteri dan kerajaan pimpinan beliau. Ini mengikut peraturan 11.3 peraturan parlimen dan menuntut tindakan segera kerana permasalahan politik yang berlanjutan. Saya ingin merujuk ringkas tentang tuduhan kasar Perdana Menteri terhadap saya mengenai surat yang terdahulu, dan saya dengan hormat dan sopan ingin menjawab dengan mengedarkan surat itu kepada awam. Surat itu menyebut keselamatan dan hala tuju kepimpinan politik negara. Kita patut fahamlah maksudnya. Takkanlah saya nak sebut yang ditandatangani oleh Tuan Guru Ustaz Hadi Awang, YB Kit Siang dan saya bersama. Saudara juga tahu dalam menggunakan bahasa, kita gunakan dengan sopan. Takkanlah nak sebut kerana kami nak gulingkan saudara, kita bincang sekarang. Jadi kita sebut keselamatan negara dan hala tuju kepimpinan negara. Tapi tak mengapalah saya memilih untuk mengedarkan hal yang sedemikian, terutama bila beliau membuat ugutan tentang saya ini menjadi ancaman keselamatan dan kemungkinan ancaman ekonomi dan kemungkinan keselamatan negara. Saya tahu tentang kedudukan ekonomi ini. Hari ini pasaran saham merudum parah setelah pengumuman Menteri Kewangan baru semalam, dan juga dengan kesan ekonomi global. Dalam semua komen penganalisis politik Malaysia dan rantau, tidak menyebut sumbangan Anwar menjatuhkan harga pasaran saham. Saya juga mengaitkan tentang peranan saya menemui pelabur dan pengurus dana yang berjumlah $1 trillion, dan dalam perbincangan hampir semua membicarakan soal daya saing, tasa ekonomi, badan kehakiman, media bebas, kadar jenayah yang mesti dikurangkan, yang menyebabkan Malaysia hilang daya tarikan. Dan ini kebetulan juga adalah dasar yang ditekankan oleh Pakatan Rakyat. Ladies and gentlemen, today I've submitted a letter on behalf of Pakatan Rakyat as leader of the opposition to the Prime Minister, requesting him to call an emergency session of Parliament to deliberate a motion of censure or vote of non-confidence against the leadership of Dato' Sri Abdullah Badawi and the government no later than Tuesday 23rd September 2008. This is in accordance with Order 11.3 of the Standing Orders of Parliament and warrants an immediate response given the gravity of today's political impasse. A delay in his response would be interpreted as nothing short of a further sabotage of the democratic process and abuse of executive power. The Prime Minister's haggling on the syntax of our first letter signed jointly by Ustaz Abdul Hadi Awang, Webby Lim Kit Siang and myself is puerile at best. The intent of our meeting as described in that letter was clearly to discuss the future course of the nation's leadership. Though in deference to his position and in accordance with acceptable norms, we remain considerate and polite in our approach. I also find the Prime Minister's comment about me in his press conference yesterday to be reckless and irresponsible in the light of the disastrous outcome of last Friday's ISA raids. This is in regard to the allegation that I am supposed to be a threat to both the economy and possibly national security, and for the pasaran saham, stock market, the share market yesterday, today, as you realize, this was immediately after the announcement of the reshuffle and the new finance minister. But I would add, it's also due to global economic conditions, particularly in the United States of America. No analysts have made any reference to me. I'm quite irrelevant in that process. As the incumbent Prime Minister actively holding office and exercising all executive powers, and as the outgoing Finance Minister, we hold him fully accountable for the current political turmoil and mismanagement of the nation's economy. I've met with key fund managers in the region, representing over $1 trillion in assets, and on multiple occasions, they were unanimously in support of comprehensive reforms in Malaysia, including judicial independence, a free media, a more professional police force, and an anti-corruption agency, an effective anti-corruption agency, investor-friendly laws and assurances on the non-interference of politicians in the governance of Bank Negara. These are policies Pakatan Rakyat has promised to implement, and initiatives that the current administration has done virtually nothing to advance since March the 8th. Terima kasih. Ini soalan? Ya. Pertama, kita mohon pertemuan. Surat yang ditandatangani oleh pemimpin ketiga-tiga parti, Ustaz Hadi, Webby Kit Siang dan saya. Dan ini ditolak dengan kasar sekali. Sekarang kita pun dah mendesak diadakan sesi khas parlimen. Dan kita akan, pimpinan Pakatan Rakyat akan berbincang semula. Sekiranya hal ini tidak berlaku, ada langkah-langkah berikut yang kita rencanakan. Yes. There's no reason why I should be arrested under the ISA. The Prime Minister and the Minister of Home Affairs are assured that there will not be any more